In any IP internetwork design, the address ranges of subnets may overlap. In a network with a single subnet mask, we can identify these overlappings. But in a network that supports VLSM, detecting the overlapping subnets becomes very difficult. As a result of the overlapping, the routing table entries in a router also overlap, and this makes routing unpredictable. You need to learn how to analyze and identify overlaps in an existing network. You should also know how to choose new VLSM subnets to avoid overlapping. Let's take a look at the diagram on the screen. Here's a single Class B network, 172.16.0.0. When using a VLSM design with three different masks, /24, /23, and /30, how can you determine whether or not overlapping subnets exist from this diagram? It's not as simple as you think it is. To determine overlaps, we need to follow a very detailed procedure. We first need to find out the address range for each subnet. To do this, we calculate the subnet number and subnet broadcast address of each subnet. In the next step, we find those cases in which the address ranges overlap. For the diagram displayed on the screen, the subnet numbers, broadcast addresses, and range of addresses of the five subnets are displayed in the table. Observe the table. The subnet numbers all appear different. So where's the problem? Let's take a closer look. Here it is. The R2 and R3 LAN subnets overlap. So the design is invalid. The only solution is to change either one of these subnets.